object. What do you mean by virtual object? What is the purpose of using virtual objects? These things we are going to discuss. Normally, virtual objects, this is also one of the concepts to recognize the application object only. But what is the differences between the virtual objects and the object identification? Now we will look at it. Come to this virtual object. Just open the PPT slides.
Did you open the session, Ganesh?
You're looking my screen?
No, not yet.
Not yet. Sure, just wait. I will show you my screen. Just look at this. Now, just look at this. You're looking my screen now?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Now, here we are going to discuss about the concept called as virtual objects. Now, what is virtual objects and how it helps us to solving the object recognizing problem in QTP? Virtual objects is also one of the objects which we are going to use in QTP. When we are going to use in QTP, if your QTP tool is unable to recognize the objects, then we are going to use virtual objects. If it is not recognizing, then it will be show the error message. What the error message will become, like a error sees, we can see an error, object not found, an error. Even though if you are using recording option or if you are running the script, it will be show the error message. Now, when virtual objects in QTP are created to resolve the object recognizing problem in QTP, when we will use this virtual objects, when an area of an application is not recognizing by QTP, then only we will use virtual object wizard to map the area to a standard class. This virtual objects information we will store in where? In virtual object manager. What do you mean by this here is, take an example. This is your application. In this application, an area, particular area is not recognizing by your QTP tool. Take an example. My QTP tool is not recognizing this total area, entire area. Then, by using object repository, we can recognize a single object. By using object identification, we can add the extra properties and we can recognize each and every object. But when a total area itself is not recognizing, then which concept I need to use? I need to use the concept called as virtual objects. So what we will do? We need to configure that one. Just look at this. Here I will open my QTP tool. Take an example. This total area itself is not recognizing. This total area, your QTP tool is not recognizing. Then what I need to do? I need to map this area. I need to map this area. And this area information, you need to store it in virtual object manager. Now just look at this, how we can map that one. Where you will find the virtual objects, go to the tools menu. There you will find virtual objects. So if you are adding the new virtual objects, then you need to select the new virtual object. It will follow the four steps. First, we need to map your virtual object, and we need to define the boundaries and the parent of your virtual object. Select the name. You need to provide the name for that particular virtual object and assign your virtual objects to a collections. These are the four steps which you need to follow. Click on the next button. Okay. Here the class we need to select here. What are the classes are there here? We can check only the buttons. Tables, list box, checkbox, and radio buttons. That's it. Okay. These are the things we can identify. We can select only. We can select only this particular classes only. we can select the classes buttons, tables, list box, checkbox and radio buttons on. So here this in your application, this buttons is not recognizing. Then what is the class I need to select here? I need to select the classes button. Then click on the next, just mark that area. This is the area which is not recognizing by your QTP tool now. Then you need to mark that area. Then how can I mark? Just click on the mark button. Just mark that with this mouse cursor. Now I'm marking this total area. Now once you mark that area, you will get the width property and I click on the next button. Then click on the next. Then here just you need to give the name of the virtual objects. You can give your name, your wish. You are, if you want to change the name, you can give it your name, or like a button's name, you can give it any name, you can give it. Then click, do you want to define another virtual objects, like you want to define another area, you information you want to capture it. If another area is also is not recognizing, then you need to select as you can define another virtual object also. No, I don't want to define another virtual objects. Then click on the no radio button. Then click on this finish button. Now where this information will be stored, what are the information, what are the area you have selected now, that area information, it will be stored in the virtual object manager. Just look at this, where you will find this virtual object manager. This is a virtual object manager information. So based during the runtime my QTP tool will identify this application buttons from this virtual object manager only, not from object identification, because this based on this information only it will identify, it will test the entire area. Now what we need to do, you need to write the script. Just click on the recording option, Windows application, click on OK button. Now I'm giving this one, just I'm giving the name and password Mercury. Then I'm clicking on OK button. Now just close this application. Now I'm closing this application. Now stop this one. Now what do you find here? Instead of win button, what is showing here? Virtual button, because it's taking as a virtual object. It's showing as a virtual button. Now I am running the script. Just click on the run button. Just I am clicking on the run button. Now just tell me my script will be pass or fail. We will look at it. It will enter in the name. But where is the Windows flight reservation page? It's testing only the OK button or all the buttons?
Everything, right?
It's testing the everything, because it's testing the cancel button also. Once you click on the cancel button, the page is closing. It's not on the flight reservation. So that's why it's showing the flight reservation. It cannot identify the flight reservation page. It's showing an error message. Suppose if you are not executing the steps, then it will be passed, because it's testing the total area of a particular button. Because we are selecting the total area, you know. So this type of scenarios, if your QTP tool is not recognizing the application, then we need to select the total area of that application, which area is not recognized. So most of the time, when we will use a virtual object, means if there is a table, there is one table is there, the table which contains number of rows and number of columns, it's not recognizing, then what we will do, virtual objects. Take an example, there is a table is there here, this is my notepad. Here I am writing employee ID, employee name and employee salary. Okay, then this contains, this is a table which contains a number of rows and a number of columns. ID I am giving here 01x and a salary was 10 and 02, then y, then 03. 04 and 30, 04, Suppose there is a table. This is a table you said. Now my QTP tool is not recognizing this table. Then what I need to do? I need to use virtual objects. Then go to the tools, virtual objects, new virtual object manager. Then click on this list. Here, what is the class I need to select here? Table. You select here. You need to select the table. So the table, how many rows and how many columns you want to this?
This table means like, can we do it to the database? No, right? Like Office database?
Which one? Office database? Database means to check the data from the database, that is totally different.
Yeah, that is exactly totally different.
That is totally different.
Okay, so this is not, okay. So what kind of tables you mean? Like,
suppose take an example. If you go from news channel websites or stock exchanges, which they contains the tables, got it? Whether it is sports and something, the tables it contains. Suppose if you want to recognize that, Mike, you are doing the testing, like that information is correct or not in that application, then you need to identify, you need to capture that table, no? Got it? So these types of things. That database, retrieving the data from the database, that is totally different. Got it? That comes under the database concepts will be there, that I am going to tell you. Okay, that is totally different. Because here we are identify the table in your application. That such type of concept you are going to use virtual objects. Retrieving the data from the database is totally different. Okay? Then here we need to select the number of rows and the number of columns. Here how many rows and how many columns you want to identify. Now here I want to identify 4 rows, 3 columns. Then here you need to select the number of rows and the how many columns, 3 columns. Click on the next button. Just mark the table where your table, just take an example. This is an application which is contains the table. Just we are going to mark it that one like this. We are going to mark like this. If you mark this one, only this information will be capture. Then you will get the width property and height property. Then click on this one. Yes, click on this one. Now where this information will be stored? This information will be stored in the virtual object manager itself. The table information will be stored like this. So here, from here also you can add the virtual objects. From there also you can add the new virtual objects information. So this is a concept called as virtual object manager in the QTP tool. This is also one of the interview questions they will ask you, why we are using virtual objects, where we will use the virtual objects, and what is the differences between a virtual objects and the object repository. Instead of using virtual object, we can directly use object repository. No, we cannot use it because that is totally different and this is totally different. Most of the time when an area of an application is not recognizing by your QTP tool, then only we will prefer the virtual object concept. Okay, so it's clear. Any doubts in this concept, you can ask me if you have any doubts.
No.
Then this is a concept called as virtual. And the next concept we are going to discuss here is transactions. Okay, now what do you mean by transactions in the QTP tool? Come to this transaction. Just look at this PPT. What I discuss, the navigation, here I show you what are the steps you need to follow. And the next concept we are going to discuss here, transactions. Now, how do you measure the required script execution time by using QTP? Normally, how we will measure the, we can measure the script by using the concept called as transaction. In the script, we will provide the start transaction, end transaction. Take an example here. There is a test. This is a test. This test which contains so many actions, like here, this is my test. It contains action 1, action 2, and action 3, and action 4. There are 4 actions are there. Now what I'm doing here, if you run this test, I'm running this test, I'm running this test. Once you run the test, you at the final you will get the result window. You will get the result window. Okay, in the result window it will be show the script execution time, like how much time it's taken for this execution, total script execution, it will be show the time. But my question is here is, it will be show the script execution time for all the actions, for action 1, for action 2, for action 3, for action 4. But my question is here is, I need the script execution time for only second action. I need the script execution time for third action. I need the script execution time for fourth action. Individual execution time, I need it. I don't want total script execution time. I don't want total script execution time. Like if you run the script, it will, because first action will be done, second action will be done, third action will be done, fourth action done. At the final, script execution time for all the actions, it will be shown. But not, I don't want like that. I need, what is the time taken for first action? What is the time taken for the second action? What is the time taken for the third action? And what is the time taken for the fourth action? Then what I need to do? Then I need to insert the transaction. First action script execution time, you need it, no? Then what is the syntax you need to write it? Services dot start transaction. Okay, what is the name of the transaction name? You can give the name. What is the first script is here? Login script. I'm giving the name. Then the first action is over now. Then here services dot end transaction. Then transaction name you need to give it here. Login. Then what it will happen? It will be show the script execution time for only first action. It will be the script execution time for only the first action. The same for the action. Here again in the beginning, you need to give services.start transaction, transaction name, services.end transaction, end transaction. The second execution time it will be shown.
These timings will be shown only in the result screen, right?
Yeah, in the result window it will be shown. Okay. Mm-hmm. It will be show the total action time also. Individual action script time also it will be shown. Mm-hmm. Okay, now just look at this. I'm creating one script here. Click on the Windows application. Click on OK. Now I'm giving this, I'm entering the name, password, Mercury. Then I click on. Take a look at this. This is a script which I created. Now, if you run the script, now I am running the script. It will be total script execution time. Just look at this in the test, in the result window. Now what is the total time it's taken? 26 seconds it has been taken. But my question is here is, I need the script execution time for only the second action. Suppose take an example, I'm inserting one more action. To insert new action, suppose this is my action one. Here I'm inserting, I'm copying this one. Again, I need to add the object repository here. Just what I will do, again we need to add the object's information here. Just delete this action. Now I will insert the transaction here itself. Here start transaction, where this is a clock symbol you are finding now. This is a start transaction. I want to start from this flight reservation. I want to count it from this time. Start transaction. Here you are booking the tickets now. Order. Booking order. Okay. Then click on OK button. So don't give the spaces. Booking order. What is the step it will become? It will be counted from this time. Services.startTransaction, booking order, then where you want to count it till this point. Now this update order I will give, I want to count here, just click on the end transaction, then booking order, click on this OK button. Then what is the step, you know, services.endTransaction, booking order, then what it will happen, my QTP tool, it will, what is the time taken for only this flight reservation script? This script only. What is the time? First, it will give the start time and it will give the end time. So what is the total time it's taken for only this particular flight reservation script? Now just run the script. Now I'm clicking on the, just close the result window. Now just run the script. Just look at the result window. Now, what is the total time it's taken? 25 seconds. If you drag down this arrow symbol, just drag it. Now, at what time it has been started? The starting time is, this is at start time. And where you place the end transaction? This is an end transaction. Now, what is the total duration it has been taken for only that script? 15.659 seconds it has been taken. 15, approximately 16, like 15.69, 6519 seconds it has been taken. Only this flight reservation script. The total script, it is taken 25 seconds. But only this line, from 7th line to this particular line, which line? 23rd line, it is taken 15 seconds, 15 point so and so seconds it has been taken. So like this, we can measure the script execution time. Got it? So this is the purpose of, normally, transaction concept is very, very useful for us, where means, normally if you are doing the performance testing, we will check the, or we will check the performance of your application based on the time itself. We are going to check the performance of the application. No? At the time, we will insert the transaction in the script. At the time, we are going to insert the transaction, so we can easily measure the time, how much time it's taking for the execution of the script. So like this, at the time we are going to use the concept called as transactions. Clock symbol, in the performance testing tool also you will use this concept, transaction concept we are going to use. So if you have any doubts, you can ask me regarding this concept, transaction. It's clear. And transaction, it's showing the time in seconds. Suppose if I need the time in milliseconds, then we are going to use the concept called as Mercury timer object. What is the concept we are going to use it here? Mercury timer object. By using Mercury timer object, it will return the time in milliseconds. So elapsed time property, we are going to use it. Elapsed time property is a property which it will return the time in milliseconds. So what is the syntax for this one? The syntax will be same. Mercury timer timer name dot start, like this. This is a Mercury, this is the syntax. If you find, if you normally you can use, if you want to need any information, the QTP tool will give us the information. Start method, this is a Mercury timer timer name dot start, like this. You can use any one property. Now the same thing here, I want to place it here. The timer name, what is the timer name you want to give? Just give the timer name. Okay, then where you want to place it, this timer name. Yes. Dot stop. Then it you elapsed time property we need to use it, because to return the time in milliseconds we are going to use elapsed time property. What do you mean by elapsed time property? Return the total accumulated time in milliseconds since the timer has started. So we need to use this elapsed time property syntax. Then here just we need to give the variable, just give this one here. I'm giving the variable as X, and here I am giving the timer name booking quotations, then message box, because to display the time in milliseconds, no, I want to display the time milliseconds, message box X. Now if you run the script, it will return the time in milliseconds. So like this, it's showing the time in milliseconds of that one. Then click on this OK button, it will proceed with that. Again, that millisecond information, it won't show in the result information. Just look at this. In the test result, it will not show. Just look at this. Here, if you drag down, because we insert the Mercury timer property, no? Start and second, here it's showing here. It won't show in the test result, it will not show. Only the transaction information will be shown in the test result information. Milliseconds property, it will not be shown. It will be like this only. You need to write the syntax. So this is a concept called as Mercury timer object. And there is some properties are there, some functions are there, sorry, some functions are there. What are the functions here? Means there is one now function is there. What do you mean by now function? Take an example, this is a now function. What do you mean by now function? Means X equal to now, and I given message box X. Then what will happen, this now function, it will display your current system time as well as date. What is your current system time and what is your date? This is a now function. Just run the script. It displaying the current system time as well as date. This is about the now function. Time function means it will display the system time, what is your system time, and date function, it will display the system date. And there is one more function is there, date differences. Okay, now what do you mean by date differences? Date differences means it will calculate the differences between two dates, it will calculate the differences between 2 months, it will calculate the differences between any years. Just look at this. How can I write the syntax? The syntax we can write like this. Just put it in a comment. How we can write the script here like this. Suppose, take an example, I given the date X. Sorry, take an example, it's date 1 equal to quotations. I given 02 minus, sorry, colon 14. Okay. Sorry. Quotations. Date 2 equal to quotations. I think it's taking in the US format 02. Sorry, we will look at it in a US format. I think it will take in the US format. 05, it's date 14. Just like this. Then here I'm giving X equal to date differences brackets. First, D stands for number of days. Here you need to give it. D means number of days. Okay, comma date 1. What is the variable? You date 1 comma date 2 brackets message box X. Okay, now I think it's in US. If it is in US, it will be show the output as 2. Now just look at this. The differences type is mismatch. Just wait, we look at it. There is a problem in the syntax. Just wait, I think I need to check it. Here I think it should not be quotations. We will remove this quotations. think, okay. Yeah, why it's showing negative means date 2 minus date 1. Quotation should not be there, because if it is a string, it should be in a quotations. If it is not, if this is not a string, we need to give it 3 minus 5. Just run the script. It's showing 2. 5 and like the differences. Okay. And if I want to calculate the months, what is the differences between months? I want to calculate it here. We need to give it here 5. Sorry, 2. Here I'm giving here 5. Here I'm giving 3. How many differences months are there? Months, no? Here we need to give it M. M stands for months. Just run the script. So 3 months differences are there. And if I want to calculate the years.
Yeah, I got the basic idea.
Got it. Why years means why you need to give it. Okay. Mm-hmm. Year means it will give the number of days. 365 days like this.
Yeah.
It will not give 1 year. It will give 365 days like this. It will give. So like this, this is a way of doing the, because in an interview they will ask the questions like how you calculate the dates, differences, months, differences, year differences, and what about them, what do you mean by no functions. These things we are going to ask you in an interview. You got it? So this is a concept called as transaction concept. And the next concept we are going to discuss here is synchronization. Okay. Now, what do you mean by synchronization? This is a concept we are going to discuss. Come to this synchronization. Take an example. There is one application is there. Most of the time, the synchronization it will affect, we will use it on most of the time on web-based application. On web-based application. Take an example. You created one Gmail page. Script Gmail login page script you created in QTP tool. Now you are running the script, you are running this particular Gmail login page script. Now while I'm running the script, simultaneously my application is opening, is doing some operations, like it entered the URL like www.gmail.com, and my application is performing an action. Then it entered the username and the password, then it click on the sign in button. Once it click on the sign in button, my application response is very very slow. That means Gmail login page is opening very slowly. Okay, is very slowly opening. Then but my QTP tool script execution is doing very fastly. Script execution, QTP script tool is doing the script execution fastly. Then your application speed is matching with the script execution speed. Application response is very slow, but QTP script execution speed is very fastly. This speed is matching with this speed. It's not matching. Then what it will happen? Yet the script will be pass or fail. It will be fail. Got it? Because always your QTP, your script execution speed should be matched with the application speed. If application is response is very slow, QTP script execution speed is very fastly, then if it is not matching, then what it will happen? Your script will be fail. Now if you get this type of situations, if it is happen during the run in the project, how we can control here? We can control by using the concept called as synchronization. By using the concept called as synchronization. Here, I cannot control the application. I can't do anything on the application. Which one I need to control here? I need to control the script. I need to control the script. In the script, we need to provide synchronization. In the script, we need to provide synchronization.
So now, something to do with wait command, Ganesh?
Yeah, that's it. Here we have the three options we have. Like here, we need to use wait call statement. We can use the wait statement, exit statement, or change in default time off settings. The third option here is using synchronization point. Using synchronization point, we can use. These are the four options. Three options are there. Now take an example. First, I will show you some error message to you. This is a script which I created. No? Now I will show you some error message in the script. Just uncomment this one. Okay. Go to the files, settings, run. Here, for Windows-based application, the default time will be 20 seconds. Now, what I'm doing here, I'm decreasing this time with 5 seconds because I want to show some error message to you. Just I'm decreased with 5 seconds. Click on apply. Click on OK button. Now, just run the script. Just observe where you are getting an error. Just observe it. Okay. Why we are getting this error? Because this, once I click on the OK button, my flight reservation application page, it's loading. But what my QTP tool is doing, it's trying to capture this flight reservation activation line. But what is the status of this application? Still it is in the loading process. Then what I need to do? I need to insert the synchronization. That means I need to insert the wait statement. Where I need to insert the wait statement? In which line I need to insert the wait statement? I need to insert the wait statement after OK button. Here, we just click on this. Click on this one. Wait for brackets. Just give the seconds. Like I can give the 5 seconds. Okay. We will give the 5 seconds. Now just open the close this application. Now just run the script once again. Okay, let's wait for 5 seconds. Proceeding. Again we are getting an error. Again, what is an error we're showing? Object is disabled mode. Because still it is in insert order process. But what my QTP tool is doing, it's trying to click on the update order button. This update order button, it is in disabled mode. Because once it is in insert order process, this button is in enable mode, this button is in disabled mode. But my QTP tool is trying to click on this update order button. That's why it's showing an error message. Then where I need to insert the wait statement? I need to insert the wait statement after insert order. Here, just click on this one. Just wait right here. Just refresh it. Just get it stuck there. Just be on the line. Look at it.
lots of disturbance over there.
Now it's clear?
No.
I think it's there is a problem with the VMware. Just wait, I will check.
Okay. Okay, maybe we can continue tomorrow then. And one more request,
yeah,
Ganesh. Is there any reason for the class moving the timings? Because I think the timings which we have earlier is the perfect timings, Ganesh.
Okay. That is
Is there any concern for you? Like, because, you know, we come back from work and then we have to rush to join the session, you know. Yeah, so, like, we couldn't pay attention. If it was little late, like 9 o'clock, our Eastern Standard Time, like, it was relaxing. And then, you know, at least we have our dinner and then. But it
that
doesn't
means,
work
what are the
for
timings?
You.
Our timings, it's like 8:30?
7:30. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, I come back from work only at 6:30, 6:45. And I just have hardly, like, you know, half an hour to just refresh, cook, and then do something.
Okay.
So if it doesn't really work out, maybe
what
we can...
What we will do, mm-hmm. I will send you the mail, okay? Tomorrow morning you will get a mail from my side. Okay? We'll fix the timings.
Okay. So if it definitely not work out for you, like, we can just stick
to
the
I need to check with Eva also. She also told, like, that she has some work. Because she need to come to the office.
No, because what she said was her concern was she couldn't make it out because 6:30 her timings, right? She will definitely be on the way and the traffic.
Yeah,
right?
I know that one. Because that's why I'm thinking of it. Okay. Most probably, I will send a mail. Tomorrow morning you will get a mail. Okay. I will
fix sure. And then can you please send this slide also? Because the slides you sent earlier, I don't see all this synchronization concept, everything in that.
Okay, I will send you that slide, this slide also. I think I sent you
two
slides.
Both of them are different, right? The one you sent earlier and this.
No. Two slides I sent it to you.
Oh, no, Ganesh. You just sent one PowerPoint.
Okay, I will send you right now. Okay?
Yeah, please.
Okay?
Okay,
I will send you the mail.
Okay? Synchronizing. Yeah, okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.